perspective. Briefly, Magna Carta 800 commemoration in Britain, in the Commonwealth, and the rest of the world. In Britain, originally when we were established in 2010, we had 27 aspirations, of which 25 have been already accomplished, including having the Queen to agree to be the patron of the Magna Carta Trust, of which I'm Vice President, and the 800th anniversary of the sealing of the Great Charter, Magna Carta. There are two that haven't been accomplished to date. We still have a hope for a national holiday on the 15th of June every year to replace the rather prosaic described the spring bank holiday on the 30th of May. Now, why not, for heaven's sake? And wouldn't that raise the profile of the Magna Carta? Because you've got to have awareness before you can get depth of knowledge. And what we're really after is the depth of knowledge. I define people's views at three levels: opinions, attitudes, and values. To me, to William, to others that I'm working with, I know the Magna Carta, the rule of law, human rights, are core values of our being. And you want to get down to that level with as many people as you can. And I agree with William, you start early. If that were nominated and agreed to the 15th of June to have a national holiday, but David Cameron, the Prime Minister, says he's not yet convinced. There's an election on the 7th of May, so I'm hopeful that I can put some pressure on one way or the other to one person or the other who will be the Prime Minister for that. Britain, BBC, is just a marvelous national treasure. Their opening salvo will be a four-part series on the Chattering Class's favorite radio station, BBC Radio 4, 40 minutes each morning, 9 to 9:40, by Melvin Bragg, straight up there on their website, ready for downloading, free and easy access to the world. It's going to start with the beginnings of the Battle of Bouvines in 1214, which the BBC described on its 800th anniversary, and I was in Bouvines in France, near Lille, as the most important battle in history that nobody's ever heard of. Hopefully, people will begin to understand when they see it there and described. Working right straight through from the Monday to Thursday to the relevance of the 21st century. It will bring in constitutional history, application, development of the rule of law, access to justice, human rights, beginning a schedule, I'm bilingual, schedule, onslaught of programming on the BBC. They'll have television. There's a four-part series for an hour each. There are two three-part series. There's several two-part series and a number of single-hour programs. It'll be on the children's channel. You may or may not have heard of Horrible Histories, but Horrible Histories will be at Runnymede in 1215 to give kids, again William, to give kids a real belief and understanding that something important happened on that day, that we have a legacy today, and they will have a legacy in the future. The BBC Parliament Channel will be doing quite a lot with it, as will BBC America, BBC World, and the World Service. The tablets of the national papers are being very supportive. We've had a huge amount of coverage already. We've got Magna Carta trails that will be up on advertising in this country, in the United States, and in five other major tourist markets about how people can link together 1, 2, 3, 4 days into a fortnight, a two-week period, if you get some people who are really nerdy like those of us here. I'm delighted that C-SPAN is here today, and C-SPAN will be available for the use of the BBC, and I can hardly wait to tell the Director General of the BBC that this is available to them to use on their channels. It'll be the biggest exhibition the British Library has ever mounted, with early February seeing the first time in history when all four of the 1215 exemplars of the Magna Carta that David Rubenstein was talking about will be brought together. The exhibition will include both the Declaration of Independence and the American Constitution. And the curator said to me about 3 years ago, if you can just get the Declaration of Independence or the Constitution to the British Library for our conference, our exhibition, we'll have people around this block queued up to see it, because these things are so important to people. Other exhibitions will be held in castles and cathedrals throughout the British Isles and scores of towns and villages. An organization of the Third Age, called the Third Age, with over 300,000 members, has plans for the British History Panels to feature talk and educational outreach across the country. There are essay competitions and debates. The Parliamentary House of Commons Committee has launched a consultation happening right now, which will have a year-long debate on a new Magna Carta. They'll argue whether or not Britain should abandon its pride of a written unwritten constitution and codify what's there and enshrine the rule of law and civil rights. There's music. At least two cantata, several rock and other pop music compositions in the Magna Carta, calypso being composed in Trinidad, and many concerts and performances scheduled in place.